Hello everyone, welcome to our YouTube channel Lomopathy, and here Samriddhi Sharma is here to guide you, and in this video we will be going to discuss ipecac medicine with you all. So when a word ipecac comes to our mind, the three symptoms, guiding symptoms, first of all comes. First is it is a thirstless medicine, second it hemorrhage, that is profuse bright red, and active and passive both, and the third important thing is constant continuous nausea. But we need to learn all the symptoms of the ipecac that I am going to discuss with you in the video. So be in touch from the first to last and let's start the video. So first of all, the important thing about the ipecac is it's thirstless medicine. Second is hemorrhage that I have discussed. And third, it is constant nausea. So you can see that whenever a patient is suffering from any of the diseases, the nausea is present, that is constant and continuous nausea. And next, the important thing about the ipecac is that it has a severe cutting pain or stitching pain, as we can say, around the umbilicus. So whenever the word comes that the patient complains of the stitching pain around the umbilicus, we have to remember the three medicines. That is ipecac, granatum, and the nux moscata. These three medicines are referred to as the pain around the umbilicus. Now moving on to the next symptom is that it has a predominating gastric symptom. So when the gastric symptom predominate, most of the practitioner gives nux vomica to the patient. But I want you to know that when you refer to the Allen's keynote, it is clearly written when the gastric symptoms predominate. So there are three medicines. First is ipecac, second is antimicrude, and third is pulsatilla. These three medicines are very important for the gastric symptoms. Now I want to discuss with you that the antium tart is a medicine for the rattling cough. As I have discussed, antimicrude is for the gastric symptoms predominancy, antium tart is for the rattling cough. So ipecac is also for the rattling cough. The cough accumulates here and has a rattling sound. So if you want to hear the rattling cough sound or the wheezing cough sound or asthmatic cough sound, you can refer the video, that link's given in the description. And it is very good medicine for the autumnal dysentery. Autumnal dysentery is like that occurs in the months of September and October. So it is a very good medicine for autumnal dysentery also. And all the complaints of the patient from head to foot, it has a constant nauseatic feeling. So we can give this medicine to the pregnant females having the nauseating feeling during the pregnancy months. And ipecac has intermittent dyspepsia that occurring the same hour, the same day, and it is periodical. So that's all the important symptoms that I have discussed with you about the ipecac. If you like it, and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching. Homeopathy.